Hi there, welcome to my channel. This is Imaneo, and in this series we are implementing a color switch game using Flutter and Flame game engine. If you haven't seen the previous episodes, I highly suggest you to watch them because it is a series. I mean, you need to follow it step by step. In every step we are implementing a part of our game. So in this episode, we are going to work with background music and sound effects in the audio effects in the game. So let's jump into the code. Okay, today I decided to run the game in a simulator to see how it looks like in a mobile device. So the first thing that I realized is that our top bar, which contains a pause icon and a score, is drawing on top of the status bar. So to fix this issue, in the main.dart, we have a row which contains the icon button and a value listenable builder which contains the score. I'm going to wrap it with a safe area widget. So the safe area draws the widgets inside the area that is safe for the app. For example, on the bottom of a status bar or on the top of bottom navigation bar. The next step is to add some sound effects and background music to the game. So the website that I'm going to use for background music is Pixabay, and it has a lot of free music to download. You can take a look, and I will put the link in the description. And the music that I chose is this one. So I'm going to download it. Okay, it's here. So this is the background music. I will name it background. The next website or tool that I'm going to introduce you is sfxr.me. So this website or this program creates randomly sound effects for you. For example, you can click on the jump, and every time you click on it, it generates a new randomly sound effect for you. And if you hit the play button, it plays the latest generated sound effect. And also you can manipulate the properties that you see here. For example, you can change this property. You can find a lot of cool sound effects for your game. For example, explosion. The one that we need is pickup. For example, when you collect a star, we need to play some sound effects for pickup. You collect a star. So I already found a really great sound effect. So it is here. I'm going to use this one. You know, it somehow matches with our game and our background music, and that's why I'm going to use this specific sound effect. By the way, when you create or generate a random sound effect, you can copy the permanent link here to use it later or share it with your team or any other use case. So I'm going to use the one that I like. Here I can download it and we name it collect. Okay, so let's import them in the game. Okay, and now we need to add this directory to the assets. Here we can say audio. Now we are ready to use these assets. Okay, so let's take a look at the Flame documentation website. Here you have the documentation, and if you head over to the bridge packages, you see that we have a lot of Flame packages, for example, Flame Audio, Flame Block, Flame Forge 2D, and other things. So I'm going to go through some of them. The first one is Flame Audio, and you can import it like this as a normal dependency, and it is compatible with the Flame game engine to run or play sound effects or background music. The other package is Flame Block, and it integrates the normal block library or block pattern to your game. So components can listen to the blocks, can have some state management in them, and it is compatible with the block library or block package. The next one is Flame Forge 2D. So this is for physics. If you need physics in your game, you can read this documentation. For example, here we have Flame Lottie. You can have some animations and something like that. Also, we have Flame Rive. You can integrate Rive animations into the Flame and other things. For example, we have Flame SVG. You can load SVG images into the game. So let's stick to the Flame Audio. At first, we need to add the dependency here. I'm going to pub spec.yaml. Yeah, we are here. So we don't know what is the latest version. So the command that we can use is Flutter pub add Flame Audio. So this command searches for the latest version, and it automatically adds the library that you wanted. For example, we say Flame Audio, and it adds the package here with the latest version, and also does a pub get to, you know, to get the dependencies and something like that. So now we are ready to use this package after we run the command. Basically, we need to call one of these functions to run the sound effect or background music. We have some documentation, but this is the simplified definition of Flame Audio. You can play a sound effect like this. You just say Flame Audio.play, and you pass the name of your sound effect. For example, let me copy this one. Also, we have Play Long Audio, and also we have Flame Audio.bgm, which stands for Background Music.play. So this one is suitable to use for background music. It automatically pauses and resumes the background music when you pause the app. For example, you hit the home button or your phone rings and this kind of things. It automatically pauses and resumes after you get back to the app. So for now, I'm going to implement the sound effect. And to do that, I need to open the player class, and where we have the collision detection logic. Yes, here we have a logic when we collect a star. So we can say flame audio dot play, and instead of explosion dot empty, we can say collect dot wave. Okay, now let me run the app to see what happens. Yes, it plays the sound effect. So we are done with the sound effect. Now let's play the background music when the game starts. To do that, I'm going to read the documentation about background music. Here it is suggested to run this initialize function when the game loads. Yes, here it says that best practice is to put this call inside your game's onload method. I'm going to find our game, my game. And in the onload, I'm going to call this initialize. Is it future? No, it is a void. Okay, and now we just need to play it. It has play function, it has a stop, and also it has pause and resume. So we can use these two functions or methods when we pause the game manually. So at first, let me play it when the game starts. We can say, yeah, in the initialize game here, yeah, we call it when the game starts and when we the game over calls. So here I'm going to call this one, and we have, let me copy the exact name, we have background.mp3 file, and in the game over I'm going to stop it. Okay, does not need the name here. Okay, we have our background music, and yes, everything works well when the game over happens. It restarts from the beginning. So now let's pause and resume it when we manually pause and resume the game. So to do that, I'm going to run it in the pause and resume game method. Okay, so I just added the flame audio.bgm.resume and pause in our pause and resume functions in the game. So now it perfectly pauses and resumes, and when you game over, when the game over happens, it restarts from the beginning. All right, guys, thanks for watching this video. I think we are done with this episode. And if you liked it, please hit the like button and also subscribe my channel. It is really a great help to me to keep me motivated to work more and publish more videos. So in the next video, I think we are going to do some performance improvements or something like that, because mainly we are done with the game, and I think the next episode is the final episode. So stay tuned. Bye bye.